Welcome. I'm going to show you a very useful tool for pivot tables. I have a pivot table with a country in the filter area. I want to filter it one by one and send this entire table to each person managing that country. But I don't want them to remove the filter and see other countries' data. So this tool will help you split a pivot table by selected items and then mail it to the relevant person. It's an XLSM file. If you want to learn the code, you can also download the XLSM file. The link is in the description. Save the files in a folder. Right-click on each file. Go to Properties and unblock them. Now go to Excel, File Options, Add-ins. Go to Excel Add-ins, Browse, and select the file. Make sure the file is added and the checkbox is active. Click OK. And now you will get a new menu, Efficiency 365. And in that, you will see this tool called Split Pivot. Make sure you click inside the desired field in filter area. There are three options here. Either you select all, and then a separate file will be created for each country. Or you select just one country. Or last option is multi-select. So I'm selecting India, Indonesia, and Philippines. Next, click on the Efficiency 365 menu and choose Split Pivot. Here you can control how the pivot table will be split. We have selected three items, so it's telling you that three workbooks or files will be created. Now, what do you want to do with those workbooks? Either you save them and then do whatever you want, or don't save them and email them. So if you choose save, it'll ask you to select a folder and also give a base file name. In this case, I have chosen demo as the file name. When you click save, at this point, nothing will be saved. But later on, when you say split, I'll be creating three files, and the names of those files will be demo Indonesia, demo India, demo Philippines, like that. Right now, I'm not going to save files. The next step is to decide, do you want to email these files? If I select it, then for every item, you will get a text box and you specify the email ID. Only one email ID per item. It checks whether the email ID is valid. If not, it'll be red color. If the email ID looks valid, then it'll be green color. Now I have put email ID for two of them and I've kept one blank. That's okay. For Indonesia, it'll simply ignore emailing the file. All three files will still be created. The last option is to check whether the final output files should only have the pivot table or another sheet with the underlying data. I wouldn't recommend that because it wastes space. Now we are ready to split the pivot. Now you will get this error. Why? Because email has to be sent through Outlook and I have not started Outlook. So another requirement for this to work is that you should have traditional or old Outlook running with the desired or correct profile. I click no, so it did not bother to send emails, but it still created three workbooks. Each of these workbooks is filtered on a particular country and the data is also filtered. So even if someone double clicks on it, they will only see filtered data. Now I have started Outlook. I have selected the same three countries and let's repeat the process. Because I'm going to use this often, I have added this to Quick Access toolbar. So that button is now available to me right here. I must be inside a pivot table filter field. Click on it and run again. Now we know exactly what to do. I'm going to say email. Type the two email IDs and click on split. Now while sending the mail, you will see this dialog. You'll have to wait for this progress bar to complete. Click on allow. When you click on allow, it only sends one mail. It'll repeat this for the second mail as well. Now why is this happening? Because this is a security feature. This happens suddenly without you doing it. You should always say deny and report it to IT. In this case, I'm going to say allow. Now we had only specified two email IDs. That's why I had to allow twice. If you are trying to do this with 20 items, you will have to do this allow 20 times. I know it's irritating, but that's the price you pay for security. You can disable this feature, but that requires admin access. How exactly to do it? I've given the link in the description. Show it to your IT team and see if they allow you to disable it. But one word of caution. After you finish sending these mails, it's a good idea to re-enable that security so that it's not misused by viruses or malware. So now three workbooks have been created. You can see them in view menu windows, book whatever number. Now this is the mailbox of the person we had specified. This person got a mail. The subject will be report for whatever is the field name, which is country, and item name, which in this case is India. File will be attached. At this point, you cannot put anything in the body text. If you want any more sophistication, the source code is available in the XLSM file. You are free to change it or modify it the way you want. If you want a more sophisticated mail merge kind of solution where you can have multiple file attachments, CCs, and so on, then Power Automate is a better way of doing it. How to do that? I already have a separate video. Have a look at it. All this programming was done by my friend Raj. Have a look at his GitHub page. So if you found this useful, share it with people and give me ideas for more videos. Recently, I reached a milestone of 70,000 subscribers thanks to all of you. So that's it for now. See you next time.